I am KL Rajashree, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, Bharat Institute of Higher Education and Research. I am going to deal with the course name, Numerical Methods, and the course code is U18 BSMA 401. So we are going to see Unit 1, Solution of Polynomial and Transcendental Equations. So in this unit, we are going to deal with the topics fixed point iteration method, Newton-Raphson method, Regula-Falsi method, then solution of linear system of equations. In the solution of linear system of equations, we are going to deal with four types of methods, two direct methods and two indirect methods. The methods are Gaussian method, Gauss-Jordan method, Gauss-Jacobi method, Gauss-Seidel method. So next, Newton-Raphson method. In Newton-Raphson method, we are going to deal with the definitions of numerical methods, the application of numerical methods. In that, the application, we are going to deal with Newton-Raphson method. In this, problems using Newton, we are using to solve problems using Newton-Raphson method. So in Newton-Raphson method, we have the introduction first. So numerical analysis is the study of procedures for solving problems with the help of a computer. It is important to realize that a numerical analysis solution is always numerical. So in this type, we are going to deal with Newton-Raphson method. So this method is quadratically convergent, by which we mean that the error of each step approaches a constant k times the square of the error of the previous step. So in step by step, we are going to deal with the problem. In each step, we are going to see the error. So the net result of this is that the number of decimal places of accuracy nearly doubles at each iteration. So we'll follow the method by each iterative methods. So each iteration, the solution will be iterated and we'll get more accurate value. So in Newton-Raphson method, we are going to deal with the topic order of convergence. So the order of convergence of Newton-Raphson method is 2. That is, if the order is 2, we'll call it as a quadratic. So and the quadratic, the order of convergence of Newton-Raphson method is 2, which is quadratic. And the convergence condition is f of x into f double dash of x, that is put inside the modulus, which is less than f dash of x the whole square. So next we are going to see how we are going to apply the formula for Newton-Raphson method. So the iterative formula for Newton-Raphson method is xn plus 1 is equal to xn minus f of xn divided by f dash of xn, where n varies from 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. So this formula we are going to use for Newton-Raphson method, and this is called the iterative formula for Newton-Raphson method. So we are going to do a problem based on Newton-Raphson method using the previous formula. That is, show that Newton-Raphson formula for root A. It can be expressed in the form. It can be expressed in the form for root A. So it can be expressed in the form, let x is equal to root A. So we are squaring on both sides. So if we square on both sides, we'll get x square. And root A, if you get the square root and square gets cancelled and you are getting A. So x square is equal to A. That is, you are assuming a function f of x as x square minus A. We are bringing that A to the left-hand side. Right-hand side, you are having the constant term A, so that we are bringing it to the LHS. So your function becomes f of x is equal to x square minus A. Now we are going to find the function f of xn. So wherever you have x, that should be replaced by xn. So f of xn is equal to xn square minus A. In the place of x, we have given xn. So f of xn is equal to xn square minus A. Now we are going to find the derivative of f of xn, that is f dash of xn. So f dash of xn is equal to 2 into xn. So the constant term will vanish, because if you differentiate the constant term, that will become zero. So now we are going to apply the Newton-Raphson formula. So what is the Newton-Raphson method formula? Xn plus 1 is equal to xn minus f of xn by f dash of xn. So xn, xn will become xn minus xn square minus a by 2xn, that is equal to xn square plus a by 2xn. We are just applying the formula. Now we are going to we are going to sum up as the two fractions, that is xn square divided by 2xn. So 1xn square and 1xn get cancelled, you will get xn by 2. And next term will become a by 2 into xn. Now from these two terms, you can take common as 1 by 2. So LHS you are having xn plus 1, RHS you are having 1 by 2 as common. So if you take 1 by 2 as common, you will get xn plus a by xn. So next, you have to, next problem is derive Newton's algorithm for finding the pth root of a number capital N. So what do you mean by pth root of a number? We are going to take x as n power 1 by p, or you will get x power p is equal to n. So if you take pth root on both sides, you will get x is equal to n power 1 by p. So now we are, I am taking the pth root on both sides. So x power p will become n. So we bring the capital N to this side. So you will get x power p minus n equal to 0. So your f of x is the function x power p minus n. So your f of xn is equal to xn power p minus n. So in the place of x, we have given xn. So f of xn is xn power p minus n. So if you are, we are going to find the derivative of f of xn. So derivative of f of xn will become f dash of xn. So f dash of xn is p into xn power p minus 1. So xn plus 1 is equal to formula. Xn plus 1 is equal to xn minus f of xn by f dash of xn. That is equal to xn minus, what is f of xn? It is x power n, xn power p minus n divided by, what is f dash of xn? P into xn power p minus 1. So xn, what is the value of xn? Xn is equal to xn minus xn power p minus n in, minus n divided by p into x power n p minus 1. So I am going to take LCM. So p into xn power p minus 1. So you have to multiply that by xn. So if you take xn power p terms as common, you will get p minus 1 into xn power p plus capital N divided by this minus into minus will become plus. So that will become plus n divided by p power xn power p into xn power p minus 1. So next, establish an iteration formula to find the reciprocal of a positive number capital N by Newton-Raphson method. So let n equal to 1 by n. So that is n equal to 1 by x. So we are bringing the n to this side. So 1 by x minus n is equal to 0. That is f of x is equal to 1 by x minus n. So what will be your f of xn? In the place of x, you should write xn. So 1 minus xn minus n. So what is f dash of xn? We are going to find the derivative of f of xn. So xn, 1 by xn can be written as xn power minus 1. So if you find the derivative, it will become minus 1 into 1 by xn square. Or you can write minus 1 into xn power minus 2. Both are the same. So our iterative formula is xn plus 1 is equal to xn minus f of xn divided by f dash of xn. That is equal to xn minus 1 by xn minus n divided by minus 1 by xn square. So if you do the simplification, you can take the LCM, some terms get cancelled, and if you simplify, you are getting xn is equal to xn square into 1 by xn minus n. So if you remove the brackets and if you simplify, you are getting the term xn into 2 minus n into xn. So based on this, we have given some more problems. That is, find by Newton-Raphson method the root of log x to the base 10 equal to 1.2. Next, by Newton-Raphson method, find the non-zero root of x plus 4 sine x is equal to 0. Next is, find the negative root of x cube minus sine x plus 1 equal to 0 by using Newton-Raphson method. Solve by iteration method. 2x minus log x to the base 10 minus 7. The next question is, find the positive roots of the equation x cube plus x square minus 100 is equal to 0. So with this, the Newton-Raphson method is over. Now we are going to deal with solution of linear systems. So there are two methods to solve the simultaneous linear algebraic equations with many unknowns. So we are going to deal with two methods. One is the direct method. Second one is the indirect method. The indirect method is also called as iterative method. So the solution of a linear system of equation, as we discussed in the previous slide, we have discussed two methods, direct method and indirect method or iterative method. In the direct method, we are going to see with Gauss elimination method. It is also called Gaussian method. Then next type is Gauss-Jordan method. In indirect method or iterative method, we have Gauss-Jacobi method and one more is Gauss-Seidel method. So first is Gauss elimination method. This was invented by a mathematician Gauss. So it is also called Gaussian method. And we are using the elimination, so hence it is called Gauss elimination method also. Gauss elimination method is a direct method which consists of transforming the given system of simultaneous equations to an equivalent upper triangular system. So we'll transform the given system into an equivalent upper triangular system. So from this system, the required solution can be obtained by the method of back substitution. So Gauss elimination method, what we are going to do, we'll discuss. So when Gauss elimination method is used to solve AX is equal to B, that is the equation. We will write the matrix A as the, so from the given system of equations, we will form the matrix A. Then we will write X. X is the variables, X1, X2, etc. like that. That is equal to B. The right-hand side of the equation will become a column matrix. So this is called the augmented matrix. So AX is equal to B. We'll write that as an augmented matrix. So A is transformed into an upper triangular matrix as we discussed in the previous slide. Now we are going to see the difference between direct and iteration method of solving simultaneous equations. It can be asked in a 2-mark question. So direct method, we'll get the exact solution in direct method. Iterative method, we'll get only the approximate solution. In direct method, the method is very simple and it takes only less amount of time. But iterative method, it is time consuming and it is also laborious. So this is the difference. This can be asked as a 2-mark question. Now Gauss elimination method, compare Gauss elimination and Gauss-Jordan methods for solving linear systems of the form AX is equal to B. So solution, in Gauss elimination method, the coefficient matrix is reduced to upper triangular matrix and we get the solution by back substitution method. So in Gauss elimination method, the coefficient matrix will be reduced to an upper triangular matrix. After converting to upper triangular matrix, the solution will be again got by back substitution method. But in the Gauss-Jordan method, the coefficient matrix is reduced to an unit matrix or identity matrix. And we get the solution without using back substitution. So the main difference is both the cases, we are transforming the coefficient matrix into some type of matrix. So elimination method, we are converting the coefficient matrix into an upper triangular matrix, where in Gauss-Jordan method, the coefficient matrix reduces to an unit or identity matrix. So Gauss elimination method, we are using back substitution. But in Gauss-Jordan, we are not using back substitution directly, as we are getting a unit matrix or identity matrix. Straight away, we'll get the solution without using back substitution. So now we are going to discuss the problems. So Gauss elimination method. By Gauss elimination method, you are going to solve two linear equations in x and y. So the problem is first equation is x plus y is equal to 2, and the next equation is 2x plus 3y is equal to 5. So we are going to write that as an coefficient matrix or augmented matrix. So the first, the coefficient of x is 1, and the next equation, the coefficient of x is 2. So the first column will be 1, 2. So second, the coefficient of y is 1, and the coefficient of y in the next equation is 3. So 1, 3. And the right-hand side of the first equation is 2, and the right-hand side of the second equation is 5. So that is written as 2, 5. So that so this is called the coefficient matrix or augmented matrix A, comma B. So now we are going to convert that into an upper triangular matrix. So for that, we are going to do the elementary transformation. So row 2 is going to be changed as row 2 minus 2 times row 1. So if you do that, the first row will be as it is. The second row only, the changes will be there. So 2 minus 2 into 1. So the first second row, first element will become 0. What about the second element, second column? Second column, 3 minus 2 into 1. So 3 minus 2 will become 1, and 5 minus 2 into 2. So 5 minus 4 will become 1. So the second row will become 0, 1, 1. Now we can use back substitution. So if you equate the elements, you will get x plus y is equal to 2, and x times 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. So you will get x is equal to 1. If you substitute that in the previous equation, you will get y also as 1. So hence, x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 1. So using Gauss elimination method, you are asked to solve these problems. Solve the system of equation by Gauss elimination method. First equation is, you are given 3 variables. We have done a problem with 2 variables. Now the problem is with 3 variables. 10x minus 2y plus 3z is equal to 23, and 2x plus 10y minus 5z is minus 33, and 3x minus 4y plus 10z is 41. Next question is, solve the system of equations by Gauss elimination method. First equation is 10x plus y plus z is equal to 9. So 2x minus 3y plus 4z is equal to 13. Then 3x plus 4y plus 5z is equal to 40. So what you have to do is first form the coefficient matrix. The augmented matrix A, comma B is equal to B. Write the integers in the right-hand side of the equation. So by back substitution, you can solve the equations. So in solution of linear system of equation, we have Gauss elimination method, Gauss Jordan method. In indirect method, we have Gauss Jacobi and Gauss Seidel. So Gauss elimination, as we discussed, we are transforming the given system into upper triangular matrix, and after that we are using back substitution. Then Gauss the next is Gauss-Seidel method. So as soon as a new value for a variable is found by iteration, it is used immediately in the following equations. So this is called Gauss-Seidel method. So give the sufficient condition of convergence of Gauss-Seidel method. The absolute value of the leading diagonal element is greater than the sum of the absolute values of the other elements in that row, which is called diagonally dominant. So whenever you are given a problem, you should check first whether the given equation is diagonally dominant. If it is not diagonally dominant, we have to rearrange the terms so that this condition is satisfied. That is, the absolute value of the leading diagonal element should be greater than the sum of the absolute values of the other elements. If this is called a diagonally dominant. If it is not satisfied, we should rearrange the equation, and we should make sure that the given equations are diagonally dominant. So we are going to discuss a problem in Gauss-Seidel method. So write the first iteration values of x, y, z when the equations 27x plus 6y minus z is equal to 85. 6x plus 15y plus 2z is equal to 72. X plus y plus 5z is equal to 110 are solved by Gauss-Seidel method. So solution, here the coefficient matrix is diagonally dominant. We have to check whether some of the leading diagonal elements are greater than the sum of the absolute values of the remaining. So it is diagonally dominant. So we need not check that. We can straight away go to the problem. So we are bringing that 6y in the first equation. We are bringing the 6y and minus z to the right hand side. So that will become 85 minus 6y plus z. So LHS will be 27x. So we are bringing the 27 to this side. So your first equation will become 1 by 27 into 85 minus 6y plus z. So similarly, the second equation we are bringing the other terms other than the y terms to this side, and we are finding the value of y in the LHS. So y is equal to 1 by 15 into 72 minus 6z minus 2z, and your z is equal to 1 by 5 into 110 minus x minus y. So we'll denote that equation, value of x as equation 1, value of y as equation 2, and value of z as equation 3. So Gauss-Seidel method, first iteration. So put y equal to 0 and z is equal to 0 in equation 1. And if you use the calculator, you can get the value of x. That is equal to 3.148. So put x is equal to 3.148 and z is equal to 0 in equation 2, we'll get the value of y. So that if we calculate, you are getting 3.451. And then put x is equal to 3.148 and y equal to 3.451 in equation 3. And if we use the calculators to calculate the value of z, you will get the value of z as 20.662. So we have done a problem with three equations. Here you are asked to solve two equations in two variables. So solve 3x plus y equal to 2 and x plus 3y is equal to minus 2 by Gauss-Seidel iteration method. So with this, this unit is what we have discussed are over. So using this, we can do all the solutions of linear equations, and I think this PowerPoint presentation will be useful for you. Thank you.